who believe that they're cold or that they don't feel comfortable being fully bodied, which is to say they believe that they're supposed to have their arm amputated, you know, like they feel alienated from an arm or a leg. You've heard of this, right? This is another psychological illness.
This has been, people have suffered from that for centuries, and some people insist on having one of their members amputated, which is, you know, hopefully doctors don't go along with that, but I have a daughter in college, she's graduating next month, but she has a teacher who believes she's plural. She always likes to be referred to in the plural. So I think we're finding new horizons.
I'm a Gemini. I fight that all the time.
It's called body integrity identity disorder. That's what it is. Also referred to as amputee identity disorder. Body integrity identity disorder. It's a disorder where one believes that one is supposed to be an amputee. And so they will find, and I can't imagine any doctor being willing to amputate a healthy limb off of somebody.
Yeah, I just go back to Genesis when it comes to this whole gender question. Male and female created them. Thank God, because it works really, really well. Yeah, you know, we're all here because there are male and female. So
from a medical perspective, the medical profession finds it very disturbing that the government should try to legislate how a doctor, a counselor, or a psychologist would interact with a patient from the top down, in that sense. Because every patient, every person, every patient has a different necessity and a different kind of therapy needed for them.
Dr. Grace Christie, physician, mother of five, and the dean of the Department of Medical Studies by the Thomas Country on 18D.